Hallo und herzlich willkommen zurück zu einer weiteren Folge Lucy the Eternity She Wished. Ich werde dieses Mal in dieser Session wahrscheinlich zwei Folgen aufnehmen. Hier wird keine Abmoderation geben in dieser Folge. Nur damit ihr schon mal Bescheid wisst. Und ja, am gestern bzw. am letztrigen Tag, sowohl sowohl vom Erscheinen der Folge als auch vom Spiel selber her, dann haben wir uns ja mit dem Vater gezofft. Einiges, weshalb wir dann mehr oder weniger Wut im Brand mit Lucy aufs Zimmer gestürmt sind und dann mehr oder weniger dran geschaltet sind, Lucy die Sache zu erklären. Okay. Und sie weckt uns wahrscheinlich jetzt gerade. Master. Ich habe den Ton übrigens schon gerade eingestellt, etwas. My body is being shaken from side to side. Master, something is shaking my body. Uff. Wake up, Master. What do you want? Still feeling drowsy, I tried my hardest to overcome the weight of my dropping eyelids. I finally managed to open, to force open my eyes. Ach du Scheiße, was für ein Anblick. Wer würde sich nicht über so einen Anblick freuen? And right before me was a pair of blue eyes the size of frying pans. Ah! Und aus dem Bett gefallen, so wie es klingt. I stare at Lucy in bewilderment as I find myself falling off my bed. It's morning now. Did Master enjoy his sleep? Before I make any attempt to talk back to her, I decide to check the time. It was earlier than usual. I let out a big yawn. It's so early in the morning. Before I could ask why I was woken up ahead of schedule, I start to sniff. I could smell something delicious. My room was filled with the mouth-watering scent. I tell myself that the neighbors must be cooking up something good. Ey, ich denke, das war Lucy. Then Lucy suddenly opens her mouth.
朝食のご用意ができました。
Breakfast will be ready soon. These words were most unexpected. Did you just say breakfast?
冷蔵庫にある材料で、
Lucy tried preparing something from the leftovers in the fridge. She hoped it will be Master's liking. Breakfast? The word has a nostalgic ring to it. When was the last time I had eaten something other than fast food for breakfast? Are there any dishes that Master dislikes in particular? No. Any ingredients then? Uh-oh. Sowas könnte doch böse enden. No, nothing like that. I wanted to say carrots and cucumbers, but I decided against it. I didn't want to be seen as an immature cat complaining about his food. It just doesn't fit my cool intellectual image. Still, haven't fully woken up yet, I confirm my understanding with Lucy once more. So, you're telling me you've made breakfast? Yes,
Lucy
tried to put her skills to the test. It will be ready in 10 minutes, so please have a drink while Master waits. A cup of water is presented to me. I was just starting to get a little thirsty too. As I grab hold of the cup, its pleasant coolness spreads along my skin. I feel embarrassed about following Lucy's order, so I decide to make a small complaint as I put the cup to, cup to my lips. Next time you should wake me up when the food's actually ready. Lucy can do it because it's unhealthy to eat before Master's stomach has fully awoken. Oh, wie süß. Drinking a cup of water is necessary to get the insides moving. Only then Master can enjoy his food. How annoying. What a strict one this robot is. I enjoy the feeling of the cold water pouring down my throat and quenching my thirst. It feels like my insides are being cleansed. Sorry. Habe ich eigentlich? Okay, gut. Gut, das nochmal gecheckt zu haben. Suddenly I realized how absurd this whole situation is. The fact that someone's preparing breakfast for me. could I still be dreaming? I feel like I'm on cloud 9. Lucy cheerfully skips towards the kitchen. I only continue to stare at her blankly. Das heißt, der Vater ist offenbar wieder bei der Arbeit. Yay. 10 minutes have passed. Only now I feel more awake. It's pain how my body is slow to start itself up. I begin to feel hungry. The smell of Lucy's cooking motivates me to drag myself out of the bed. I head straight to the kitchen table. Okay. I'm stunned by the very table feast laid out before me. A cloud of rice steam is rising from the bowl of rice. Juhu! Oh, stimmt, das ist ein Reiskocher. The soup is boiling with intensity. The sound it's making is music to my ears. And there's a perfectly prepared fish along with a variety of side dishes. It would be shameful to compare this to a lunchbox from a convenience store. Und sie ist stolz darauf. Appearing to have sensed my delight, Lucy smiles pleasantly. Das blickt gerade. Her voice is full of teas.
Ahem.
Ahem. I feel a sense of defeat. I begin to feel frustrated for no particular reason. I want to say something in reply but decide to hold back. I take a seat in silence and lift my spoon.
Oishii desu ka?
Oh, that's a taste. I haven't even taken a bite yet. What's the rush? Just hold on for a second.
Sasa, sameru mai ni meshiagatte kudasai ne.
Yes, yes, please start before the food gets cold. Oh, wie süß. Lucy takes a seat at the opposite end of the table. While striking a sly pose with a hand on her chin, she urges me to eat. It was as if the food was suddenly going to disappear if I didn't start soon. Mit den Roboter ist echt knuffig irgendwie. She's gazing at me intently. She's trying to make it obvious, but I can tell that she's very eager to see my reaction. Whatever I say, next will decide what her face will show. I take a spoonful of the glossy white rice and put it in my mouth. It's good. Perfect flavor and texture. While I'm at it, let's try some side dishes too. Marvelous. She really wasn't lying about her cooking skills. Let's be fair though. She probably knows only the best recipes from around the world. And since she's a robot, there wouldn't be any inconsistencies in her cooking. If they had programmed her to be a top level chef, then this was to be expected. There's nothing to be surprised about. But the robot's just a robot. She wouldn't be able to top something that Mama used to make, as I say. Also, personally, I've never had an opportunity to taste my mother's cooking, so I can't compare. Oh, das ist eigentlich ziemlich schade. Looking back at Lucy, who was still staring at me with great anticipation, I think about what I should say. I can feel an aura of confidence around her, yet she appears to be worried at the same time. She's expecting me to say something. I finally make my reply. Nee, das ist fies. Außerdem, ich mag Lucy, ich finde sie süß. Well, it tastes alright, I guess.
Yokatta desu!
What a relief. Even with my meek response, she still lets out a big sigh of relief. Lucy was so worried that Master might not enjoy her cooking. Lucy was lacking the initial data. You don't need to concern yourself with that. I've been eating fast foods all my life. I will eat anything, even if you make me some porridge from pig intestines.
Oh,
is that how Lucy's cooking tastes like? Okay. Okay, wieder umstellen. Gut. Please forgive Lucy for a lack of skills. Oh, Lucy truly is a failure of an android. She actually looks pretty depressed about this. She looks as if she is about to run off while leaving behind a trail of tears. Am I supposed to chase after her while holding a piece of bread in my mouth or something? No, that's not what I meant. I'm saying that it tastes better than what I had expected. So you don't need to beat yourself up over it. Oh, wie sie guckt. Wie so ein... Oh, ja, wie so ein Welpe. Cute little puppy. Oh, da möchte man einfach den Kopf schon rubbeln. Is that true? Yeah. Can Lucy really trust Master with those words? It doesn't take long for Lucy to cheer up and start humming away happily. It's nice that she's easy to deal with. I continue to eat in silence while checking up on her after every few spoonfuls. I can't tell how much time has passed. Okay. Good. I can't tell how much time has passed. The bowl of rice I had been eating from has started to show its bottom. I steal a glance at the clock. It's not yet time to leave for school. While reveling in my satisfaction, I decide to sit back in my chair to chill out for a bit. Some time passed while cleaning up the empty dishes, Lucy asked me a question. Her tone was quite delicate, as if to soothe a small animal. Pardon Lucy for asking, but there's something she has been wondering about since yesterday. What is it? She seemed to be hesitating, so I gave her a little push. Go ahead. The reason why Master hates robots is due to father's influence? The question catches me off guard. All the unpleasant memories involving my father come flying back. I slowly realized that my chopsticks were frozen in midair. Without missing a beat, I continued delivering the food to my mouth. In an attempt to hide my surprise, I purposely gave a curt answer. Well, I guess you could say that. Nothing would change from denying it. I put down the chopsticks and lock eyes with Lucy. This robot just laid to waste the value of and beliefs I have had for the past 18 years. Keeping my eyes on the robot, I muse. Now that I think about it, I was probably brainwashed. By brainwashed, does Master mean... I have heard nothing but awful things about robots since I was little. Robots are bad, robots make us ill, robots harm society. I grew up listening to that all the time, so it sort of rubbed off on me. The previous generation of IT. Now the new generation of robots. As long as we live sandwiched between two generations, there's bound to be people advocating against new technology such as robots. There are plenty of people out there who are strongly opposed to the production of robots. My father is a prime example. Similar to what happened during the Industrial Revolution, the effects of this profound new technology is gradually expanding across the globe. Robots are slowly taking away people's job opportunities. It costs less to maintain robots than to pay employee salaries. Robots never complain in their consistency in their performance, unlike people. They don't feel any stress or pain, and they never mess around. It would be much easier to deal with a robot than to fuss over a troublesome worker. We are only beginning to find out what kind of changes robots will bring to our society. Unemployment is getting out of control. All the newly formed jobs are being handled by robots. This is why many people shun robots. No one understands whether this is a temporary phenomenon arising from the drastic changes in our lifestyle, or if it's a type of psychological disease. It will only become clearer as time goes on. One thing I can say for sure is that there has always been a divide amongst the population, as made evident by the Luditism movement in the early 18s. Some are more willing to accept this new technology, while some are not. To me, a world run by robot doesn't seem too promising. It was too late by the time I had finally grown old enough to be able to think for myself. It's not as simple as just changing my perspective, because maybe I still would have turned out like this even without my father's influence. My hatred for robots has simply become part of my life now. The most horrifying part of brainwashing is that you can never fight against it. It's technically impossible to bend someone completely to your will. You can't do anything about people acting loyal on the outside but despising you on the inside. Brainwashing is different, however, because the person wouldn't have the knowledge to think for himself in the first place. And it's possible to take advantage of that by bit. As long as the victim never comes to realize this, he will never be able to retaliate. There also needs to be a compelling reason for him to change. Even with a good reason, it's likely that he won't be willing to accept it. Because if he did, he would be going against all the beliefs he had had for his entire life. It would crumble the foundation of his very existence. The older a person becomes, the harder it gets for him to admit that he has been in the wrong. Who knows? Maybe I would have never come to hate robots. It's too late for me to start thinking about that now. About that, so.
Lucy
really hopes that
Master and his father will come to appreciate robots.
And appreciate Lucy. Ja, ansonsten sitzt sie auch vor der Tür. Das wäre nicht so optimal für sie.
She wants to get along with everyone.
Upon hearing that, I unknowingly let out a bitter laugh. You saw what my father did when he found out you are a robot. You're asking for the impossible. It would be a relief in itself if nothing happens to you behind my back. Lucy understands that, but... Your wishes remain the same. I say softly. She's failing to think logically as a computer. Even after hearing that my father wants to throw you out, how could you still hope for something like that? If person A hates person B, it's likely that person B will come to hate person A. At least that's how it is normal human relationship. Now, das will ich eigentlich nicht so sagen. So how come Lucy can't grasp it? Ich würde nicht sagen, dass Person B auch, dass normal ist, dass Person B dann auch anfängt, Person A zu hassen. Ich würde eher davon ausgehen, dass Person B einfach nichts mehr von Person A halten würde und einfach, ja, sich mit Person A nicht mehr abgeben würde, nach dem Motto so, da kann man nicht ausstehen. Ist mir scheißegal, ich brauche mit dem nichts zu tun haben, so ungefähr. Da kann mich machen, das ist ja aber nicht hassen, das ist einfach... Das ist einfach sozusagen... Ich kann mein Leben auch ohne diese Person leben, das macht für mich keinen Unterschied, so in die Richtung. Also, hassen finde ich da eigentlich... den Vergleich finde ich nicht so optimal. So, come Lucy can grab this? Because she's very patient and forgiving. No way. It's because she's a robot that knows how to suppress its emotions. It's because she isn't human. Lucy thinks that father is just as kind-hearted as master is.
Lucy
can tell. That's why she hopes that he will maintain a healthy relationship with master. Refuse you to, of course. You are already mistaken by calling me kind-hearted. And it's not just your father. She just ignored me. That little
master,
the man at the repair shop and the researchers at the lab. They're all nice people.
To be of a big help to everyone, including Master.
That is Lucy's mission and her wish. It definitely sounds like something a robot would say. It doesn't seem like she's capable of sorting the good from the bad. I can't help but give her a cynical reply. In the end, we are the same. You've also been brainwashed, but in a different way. Lucy slightly tilts her head at his side. She seems to do that whenever she is confused about something.
Master,
could Master elaborate? You will love humans. That's essentially what's been programmed into your main system. You have no free will, that's an illusion. You have no choice but to act in this way. She tilts her head from side to side. Oh, das ist eine harte Nuss zum Nachdenken für einen Roboter, glaube ich. She doesn't seem to understand. You want to help everyone, right?
Hi.
Yes, of course. And you're happy when you help people.
Hi.
Yes, Lucy is very happy. Why do you think that you want to help others and that you feel happier once you do?
So desu ne. Donna ryū de shou ka?
Lucy has no clue. It's because the program those researchers put inside in you is forcing you to feel this way.
So de shou ka?
Really? Yeah. Your will and your personality are yours. But at the same time they aren't. They are from the people that made you. They programmed you this way and you are simply following orders. You're nothing but a puppet on stage whose strings are being pulled.
Das ist eigentlich schon ziemlich fies, das so zu sagen, aber es stimmt ja irgendwie auch.
It may look like it's moving by itself at first glance, but it's actually being held up by wires. And there are people behind the stage controlling these wires. That's who you are. You're only moving according to how they want you to move. The pupils in Lucy's eye diminish. She appears to be deep in thought. Lucy still doesn't understand what Master is saying. I am saying that your actions have no actual meaning. You are just a toy made to do a certain task at a certain time. Nothing about you is real. There's no significance. Do you understand? The mind, its emotions and its intuition on the inside. The body, its movement and its reaction on the outside. If they are just part of a computer algorithm created by someone, then they aren't genuine. Any gestures, any sentiments, there's no meaning behind them. I stress that idea over and over again. Something like that doesn't have any meaning. That isn't true, Master. She started me with a sudden rebuttal. I wasn't expecting that from her. What are you talking about? There definitely is a meaning. Okay. Boah. Listen, knows. You're saying that there is a meaning? You still don't get it. You were made to be friendly with humans through a program. It's not by your own choice. Your actions and feelings, they're all artificial. That's why they're meaningless. It doesn't matter where Lucy's feelings come from.
What?
No matter who's controlling Lucy, if Lucy helps someone, the person will be happy. And if he's happy, Lucy will be even happier. Because Lucy was able to help someone in need. In the end, both the person and Lucy will be happy. And Lucy is satisfied with that. Even if she was created for this purpose. Even if she's acting on someone else's will. That's not important to Lucy at all. The fact that Lucy helped someone, how Lucy felt by helping someone, how Lucy was thanked for helping someone. Master may call such feelings fake.
Because Lucy was made to feel and act this way. But to Lucy, this is very much real, and this is where she finds meaning in her life. Nonsense.
Oh,
my name is Lucy Valentine. Lucy states her name, as if she is announcing herself before a crowd. She also did not refer to herself as in third person. The name Lucy comes from a Latin word meaning light. To become a messenger of hope. That's how Lucy interprets her name. Helping people finding a sense of accomplishment. This is what Lucy lives for. This warm, fuzzy feeling in her heart after helping someone. Even if she was made to feel this way. These feelings are definitely real to Lucy. And that is why she will continue to help people. I tried to say something back, but the words never came out. It felt as if there was something stuck in my throat. It wasn't exactly because I agreed with her. And it wasn't because I was touched by her words either. I actually thought she was stubborn. As stubborn as a mule. It was rather because of how Lucy appeared so major and real. The way she confidently stated her opinion. Nothing about her was remotely close to my idea of a robot. That is why I could only sit in silence. Headed to school in my mind in a haze of confusion. My emotions were in turmoil.